Okay, big crowd here today. Two bitches. First of all, if you've noticed, the name has changed. It's UIW. I mean, yeah, something like that. Anyway, there's going to be a lot of new changes around here. More PG, more family friendly. And also, probably my proudest, is a new GM, Dr. Bringle. A man of integrity and a man who stands up for what he believes in. And here he is. Dr. Bringle, why don't you tell everybody a little bit of the different things that you're going to be doing around here?
Well, the good thing about being a third party brought in here is I come from a neutral standpoint, and things are going to be completely different. I'm not playing any favoritism. Things are getting changed, ground up, making stuff happen.
Says goes. He may get some of his ideas from me. Maybe he will, maybe he won't. He says jump. You say how high.
How high? That's something that Bringle should know a lot about. Real quick though, I want to go on to bigger and better things. Bringle knows what's going on. He's making all the decisions. He knows that I am the main star attraction, the best there is and the best there ever will be. It's a little bit of Bret Hart for you. Yeah. You wouldn't smirk. I've beaten every superstar in this backyard, including this guy, whenever he was some flamer running around with a fucking fire on his hat. I've laid out Chris Jones before for the world championship. I've taken care of Rob Slater. I've taken care of Drew Parsley. I've done it all. I've seen it all. You two can't tell me anything new, nothing that I haven't seen, nowhere that I haven't been. There's a loophole in every system, and I will find your guys's. And there's no consequences. No, there's none. You set up your rules, and there will be nothing that you can do to stop me from obtaining what I want, when I want.
How you doing? When you're ready to drop that zero and get with the heroes, you definitely know who to call. But anyways, on to bigger and better things, like JP was saying. Rob Slater. The one man that hasn't beat me in wrestling, ever.
Central one.
Any company, any place, nowhere, no time, not happening. And I don't ever remember you laying me out, but that's besides the point.
I remember back in August, in that yard over there that I laid the best out for. It's right here.
All right, anyways.
That's my recollection.
I'm coming for that. No matter for friends, it'll be great. But I will walk out champ.
Thanks, Cino. That's very inspirational. Ooh, got tears in my eyes. You've beaten everybody, haven't you?
Everybody that you put in my way.
Rob Slater.
Rob Slater? Check.
Yeah, genocide.
Check.
Mr. Bringle.
Slater, check.
You have. You've done about everything, haven't you?
Everything there is to do.
Check everybody. Now, as you check those names off, is there a check beside my name?
A check beside your name. All right, listen here, Mr. Gacy. I'm going to go ahead and point out some things to you. The way you run this company, making three titles, active titles, this thing you call the Hell in a Cell belt, the piece of shit that I wear around my waist, I did it to entertain you.
You have trouble getting off?
I don't want your piece of shit belt anymore. I want the real gold, where it's at right here. You want to step in the backyard? You want to be a world champion? You want to be a star? I will make you famous. Is that what you want, William Gacy?
You know, like I said, Mr. Pringle has 100%. It's easy to say for me. 100% control of the company. What do you think about a match? For his little trinket there.
I don't know. I remember this cocky son of a bitch from back in the day, keeping me down as a wrestler, thinking he was the big shot around town and everything like that. But the tables have turned now. it's weird now, you being on the receiving end of all this punishment. How about we do something crazy? Get the party started right, if we will. How about you defend your UIW Legacy Championship belt against, I don't know, someone who's never stepped into the ring in the backyard before? William Gacy.
Gladly.
Tonight.
There's only one little stipulation. Your little butt buddy here, C-No, he can get to walking. He is banned from ringside.
I don't want these
if
fuckers
I see,
what?
Is my mouth moving? Because if my mouth moves, I'm talking. You shut the hell up. Get to stepping, all right? Don't let the door hit you on the ass on the way out.
You got it.
Oh, by the way, I need a referee down here. I don't think I'll be needing you guys. This should be well under control. Mr. Bringle, why don't you escort Ms. McVey back to the back?
Come on, guys.
Who are you rooting for? Come on, guys.
I'm gonna get mad.
We're an opposite teams. I can't believe it's Chris Jones. Are you kidding me right now?
Is somebody gonna ring the bell?
Check in first.
This match hasn't officially started yet until somebody rings the bell. Mr. King.
That's how it's done.
Oh, Mr. William Gacy. Down on the ground.
Some walls?
Yeah.
The Lucid Tamer.
Going for the Lucid Tamer. And he's got it locked in.
Come on.
What the hell is this? What is this? Mr. Gacy haven't helped to win this match? No?
Oh!
Spear!
Get him up.
I think he's out cold. After that belt shot, it's gonna take a miracle to kick out.
One, two, three.
And that's the match. Mr. William Gacy. The new UIW Legacy Champion.
Yeah, Mr. McVey.
Adding insult to injury.
Take a shot for yourself. You must be a pretty boy.
Enough of this. The man is already down. What's Mr. William Gacy doing? No. Oh my God. Oh.
Well, look how far we've fallen. Mr. Slater.
What are you doing?
I'll do the talking. You just need to shut the fuck up. Alright? Hey, you want your job back or not? You know, you got shit canned. You got shit canned for a lot of reasons, didn't you? Well, you know, I stood here and thought about it. And we need a jobber. Someone come in, everybody beat the shit out of. Go home, get their paycheck. Tell you what, me and Miss Shively been thinking, there might be a way of getting your job back. It's not gonna be easy. It's not gonna be easy. Take a look at these documents. See if you agree with them. If you don't, well, you don't have a job. If you can agree to all those stipulations, you can get your job back. Well, there's a bunch of stipulations, Mr. Slater. Let me tell you that right now. So I'll tell you what, you know what? You got 24 hours. Give me your answer.
24 hours.
24 hours. Like I say, if you want your job back, Mr. Slater, the cheap shit even? Really? Maybe you should actually just sign these right now so you can actually have a job. Think about it, Slater.
Really? 24 hours to be a jobber? One of the greatest stars this company's ever had. And I'm stooping so low as to call me a jobber? I've beaten every talent he has in this business. Every single talent. There's nothing that Mr. Keene can do that can stop me, the essential one, Rob Slater, from returning to this company. I'm gonna do whatever it takes. Even if I have to sit a chair in the middle of the yard and sit there, not let anything go on until he comes out and confronts me face to face. Jobber. I was the hottest talent on the market. Still am. I don't have to sign with this company. But my heart and soul is in this company. I've spilled so much blood, sweat and tears over this company. 24 hours for these documents to be signed and an answer. He'll get his answer. And he's got a lot more coming to him than just an answer.
Making his way to the ring, he hails tonight from Atlanta, Georgia. He stands at 6'2" and weighs 160 pounds. The former BYWE World and Legacy Champion, Rob Slater!
Give me the microphone.
There you go, sir.
I want Mr. William Gacy to come out here right now. Because I have his answer.
Yes or no?
No. I'm not gonna be a jobber in this business. I'm gonna be the main event star that I am. Don't try to take this away from my mouth. Okay?
That's the first thing you take away from your mouth, isn't it?
You don't want to be a jobber. You know, all around Shelbyville you go to gas stations, and inside it says, for the best blow job in town, call Rob Slater. For the best hand job in town, call Rob Slater. And all of a sudden you don't want to be a jobber? Well, let me tell you what. That's the only thing you're going to be good for. It's the only thing you have been good for. It's the only thing you ever will be good for. So why don't you take this microphone and see how far you can deep throat it.
You see, if I wasn't trying to get my job back right now, I'd beat the living hell out of you. So I got one question to ask you. Are you going to make me main event status? Yes or no?
Let me tell you this. If you were main event status, the only thing you'd be main event status for is be a male gay porno star, all right? That's the only thing you'd be main event for. So won't you take your little fucking chair and your little baseball bat and your little ass and get the hell out of my arena?
Let me see. I'm not. I'm just going to take this little chair, set it right here, and I'm not going to leave this yard until I get the main event status I deserve.
Oh, Mr. Slater. Poor, imbecile Mr. Slater. You don't understand it, do you? How many times have you been the UIW champion? Zero. I'll answer it for you. I know you can't count that high. So I don't see why you think that you could be a main event status star. Give me one reason, just one, okay? Can you count that high?
Yeah.
Okay, same as your IQ, so take it slow, okay? I'll talk really slow for you, okay?
Because I've beaten everybody in this business except for one person. Everybody. Everybody put in that ring with me, I've beaten them except for one person who gets lucky every time. Chris Jones. And if I had it my way, if I was the owner and I wanted to see a good match, if I wanted to see a bloodbath, I would put me versus Chris Jones.
It's kind of funny using the word good in front of your name at all for anything. But anyway, what do you think, Mr. Bringle?
I don't know, since I'm kind of spicing things up tonight, let's kick up another notch. How about a all for nothing match, if you will? If you lose, let's start. If you win, you can have your job back, and you can have the number one contender shot, whatever, you know, whatever floats your little fire crotch boat. But if you lose, you're walking off the roster, out of the ring, removed completely from the memories, for good. You understand that? I know you didn't pass third grade. Like, it's done.
Yes.
I accept, okay? Just tell me who my opponent is. Just tell me who's good enough to step in the ring.
Didn't you tell us who your next opponent is?
Making his way to the ring at this time, he hails from Shelbyville, Indiana, weighing at 154.3 pounds. He stands at 6 foot tall. He is C unit, Chris Jones.
Final touch already, TFT, as Rob Slater calls that. Go for the big move early, gonna put his opponent away. We got a roll up. Uh-oh, goes down. One, two. Two count only. Chris Jones with the right hand to the skull, to the back, clubbing him down. Rolling him over. Uh-oh. Oh, he goes for that Jeff Hardy innovated leg drop to the groin. And he's going for the walls of Jones already.
Ask him, come on.
He's gonna ask him. He's gonna ask him if he taps. Will Rob Slater tap? Will he give up? He's crawled to that fence, that chain link fence. He gets off. Chris Jones is not like he is through by a long shot. It's like he has just started. He has just started, folks. Rob Slater favoring that back there after that walls of Jones. See if that comes into play throughout the rest of the match. Nope, reverse. Oh, into the damn cage, son of a bitch. Oh my God, stop the match, folks. Stop the damn match. It's like a damn car wreck out there. Chris Jones, his motionless body just laying there. Rob Slater, oh, you son of a bitch. You sick son of a bitch with the steel chair. He's gonna go for that damn ankle. Don't put that, no, don't. Oh my God, Rob Slater. Maniacal Rob Slater, son of a bitch, stomping on that chair repeatedly. He's gonna snap that damn ankle in half. No one else commentate. Setting up the chair. Let's see what we got here. He's going for a vertical suplex. Very much vertical, straight up and down, onto his back. Billy King joining us at the commentating booth over here. No, he's not. He's smoking a cigarette. I lied. Rob Slater giving The camera's not. What the fuck is he doing? What's that son of a bitch doing? He's going. He's going for vintage Justin Parsley.
I'm gonna end this.
A one-man concerto. No. Misses. Roundhouse kick from Chris Jones. This isn't looking too safe. He blocks it. Spins him around. Oh my god! Threw the damn chair. I don't know who got the worst end of that deal. To be honest with you folks, Rob Slater literally just fucked himself up in that lower back that he was favoring earlier. Yeah, three,
four,
five,
six.
Both men down, get up before the seven. 10, he's up. You got one man up.
Eight.
Chris Jones making his way back up now. What the hell is Rob Slater doing? Fucking up that $13 chair that I went out and bought last year. Treating it like it's their own. That's cute. Oh my god, what's happening here? Straight into the damn pole! Rob Slater is fucked up. Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Rob Slater seems down and out. Chris Jones, he has something in mind here, it looks like. Nope, he's favoring that left ankle.
Slater! Slater! Slater!
We got a Slater chant started over here in the crowd. We got a Slater fan in the audience. Senior referee Mel Mall out there. Calling the match how he sees it. We got a cradle power driver. And Rob Slater, his head driven right into that damn yellow steel chair. It could be over with. We got a one, two, two count. He's tuning up the band, it looks like. We're gonna see the elevator. He ducks, he misses. Oh my god! Face first, he's down for the pin. One, two, two count only. I think if the referee would have been down a little bit quicker, we would have had a three count. The referee shrugs like, yeah, you're probably right. I like a referee that can admit his own flaws, unlike Benjamin Kaufman. Just his only flaw is being retarded. Chris Jones calling for it. Is he going for a headbutt? What the hell is he going for here?
Well, there could be a death peak on top of that.
No No, he's not.
Oh my God!
Super TFT, the final touch, will that be all it takes right there? One, two,
two count only!
Oh my God.
You're gonna give me a three signal. I'm just saying what I see, motherfucker. What? I mean,
drop the
chair shot. That's gotta be all. One, two, two count! No, Maul calls a two count. Claire's into it. It's too intense for her.
Oh my God!
TFT onto the chair. We got it. One, two,
two count again. Nothing will keep Chris Jones down.
He's immortal.
Get out of the way. Get out of the way. I'll hit you. You better move.
Super kick into the chair. He's going for the
Jones clash. That could be it.
One, two,
three. It's over with.
Chris Jones. Chris Jones.
Get that.
Justin.
Yeah, I don't
and
think they didn't
tell
me this.
Because, like,
they made it
for
them.
He said, I was almost gonna stay.
But I was like, wait, is that gonna be?
Am I doing any more matches? No.
Zoey McVey. Hey, cutie.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Looking for sugar.
Looking for sugar. Well, I mean, I'm sweet like sugar. Maybe just dip my finger in there and sweeten it up for Billy. Is that what you're wanting? William. Mr. Gacy. Whatever he's wanting to go by nowadays.
I'm not sure he's like that.
You're a fine little piece of ass. You know that?
I know.
I like that confidence in a girl. Confidence. Man, you're smart.
Got a problem here? Mr. Parsley? Mr. McVey? Is this part of my coffee right here?
Well, I said I could dip my
I am talking to Miss McVey, all right?
You're going to push the wrong button.
Hey, first of all, why don't you just get your little ass out of here, all right? I got to go have a little talk with Mr. Parsley, okay? Just go. You know what? I'll tell you what. You stay away from my property, all right?
Your property?
She gets paid by me. She's my property.
What kind of
does
a dude
does she get
are
paid
you?
By me?
Yeah, I guess.
So I'll tell you
that
what.
That makes one of us, at least.
A little sexist, egotistical, lying, hypocritical bigot. You need to get the fuck out.
All I heard
you
was
got
compliments.
You know what?
I
think you got a fucking match, don't you? So won't you just worry about that?
Yeah, worry about that.
Coming into the ring, with 5 feet 10 inches, 160 pounds, from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, Justin, above par, Parsley.
the UIW Heavyweight Champion in the ring right now. Talking to the ref. I believe this is the number one contender.
Now coming into the ring at a height of 6 feet, weighing in 154.3 pounds from Shelbyville, Indiana, C Unit.
What? Dude, I'm not.
It's only a dollar.
No, I'm not that. Like, we're partners, bro. I'm not gonna defend my title against you.
Well, we got a little bit of change of plans here, guys. We've seen this match many, many times, haven't we? Sometimes Justin. Sometimes him.
It's a good match, always.
Sea Dog, whatever. Okay, but we've got a little difference here. This is going to be a triple threat. I'm going to throw another warrior into this ring. A 5'10", 245-pound warrior.
McDonald Eaton.
Down from the Sunshine State. Japan? The Seminole Warrior. Mr. Parsley, I think you'll recognize him now, won't you?
I didn't get a very good look. You attacked me whatever in my eyes.
Sunshine, Japan. Right this one?
This match is for the UIW Heavyweight Championship.
When that bell sounds, your ass is mine. No more sneak shots.
Your ass is grass, we're gonna smoke it.
What's this guy doing?
Looks like he's about to do a spinaroonie.
And the match is underway. Looks like both of them are just beating the living hell out of the Seminole Warrior. Oh, double drop kick. Oh. Justin going for the pin.
Two.
Chris Jones with the save. Chris Jones going for the pin.
One, two.
Justin Parsley with the save.
What the hell, man? I want the belt.
Oh. Flying drop kick. The Seminole Warrior might be out cold.
Time.
Is the hair past the fucking freckle, dude? What does that watch?
With the spear. Seminole Warrior with the spear. Chris Jones trying to go for the pin. The Warrior makes the save. The Warrior with a double body splash.
Oh, my testicles.
I'm surprised the Warrior's not trying to go for a pin right now. He's just looking to dominate this match. Into the fence.
That's gonna cost.
And the champ is out of the yard.
Hey, watch the hair. I paid for this.
Two.
Oh.
Watch the house. He paid for it.
Chris Jones. Oh. I think he's trying to break the leg of the Warrior. Is the champ still outside the ring? Oh, the champ's back in. He's just trying to gain his breath. Chris Jones trying to do a submission move to the Warrior. And here comes the champ with the drop kick. Going for the pin.
One, two.
Two count. Trying to go for the pin on the Warrior.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Chris Jones breaking up the count. And the enziguri from the champ.
I'm the king of the world!
suplex from the champ to Chris Jones. The Warrior. Oh. Warrior finally getting involved in this match. And they're both down. The Warrior. He's trying to go for the... What is he doing? He's got the figure four locked in on Chris Jones. Is he going to tap?
No.
Nope. Rolling thunder from the champ. And a drop kick from the champ. Another rolling thunder. To Chris Jones. With the pin. One.
Two.
No. Two count.
I need an EMT.
The Warrior. One count. One count. What is the Warrior doing? Is he setting Chris Jones up? With a super clothesline. Chris Jones down and out. He lays them both right next to each other. No. Picks the champ back up. With the cross face.
Yeah, look at my Warrior baby. Look at him. That's the reason he's in here. Take that piece of shit out. Yeah, baby.
Mr. Gacy commentating at ringside. What is Chris Jones doing? He's bending the knees. He's got those braces on the knee. Are these two working together, trying to take out the Warrior? The double Boston Crab?
No.
If he were to tap right now, who would win this match?
Maybe couldn't do that to Seawater because he doesn't have, or what his name is, because he doesn't have a backbone.
Talking trash about C-Unit, Chris Jones. He's got the title.
Seawater, Seagull, C-Line, whatever the hell you want to call him.
What is Chris Jones doing? Hits the Warrior with the title.
Shoulder.
Is he not going for the pin? No? He's laying the title on the Warrior. With the splash. He's pinning him. Refy's got the pin. Refy's got the pin. Count it.
We're going to get another ref.
What are those on your face?
We might have to bring a special guest enforcer out here.
To see, aren't they?
Yeah.
And the Warrior levels Chris Jones with the title. Oh my goodness. The Warrior is out. Drop kick from the champ to the Warrior. Oh my goodness. He's just beating the shit out of Warrior. Where did Chris Jones go in all this mess? Is he going for the pin? He is. And Chris Jones is back to kick the ref. Why did he kick the ref? The ref should disqualify Chris Jones. What is this? Oh, now we see where Chris Jones went. Not this. Through. Oh my goodness. Is there going to be a pinfall? No, he's got the pin.
One.
Count it, ref.
One. Two.
The Warrior makes the save.
Oh my God.
Oh. The Warrior should have just tried to cover somebody. What is the Warrior doing? Oh my goodness. And Chris Jones is down and out.
You know, my yard looks like Safer and Son just visited it.
The Warrior got the chair, throws the chair down, puts the champ on top of it. Grabs the other chair. What is he doing? No. One man concerto? No, he blocked it. He just blocked it. Oh, body splash with the chair. He's got the pin. One, No! The warrior kicks out.
That's right, he's a warrior.
And the champ destroying Chris Jones right now. What is this? He's got a light bulb. Oh. No, what is this? Oh my God, over the back of the champ. He just broke that light bulb.
Ref. Ref.
What is the warrior doing? What is he doing? They just broke the banner. Chris Jones with the crutch. He's already got two injured knees. He's trying to re-injure the knee. Now he goes over to the champ. Oh, that had to hurt his throat, ladies and gentlemen. Double arm DDT to the warrior. Is Chris Jones just playing with these two? Just taunting them? He's got the champ up. Back body, no! Oh, super kick! And Chris Jones just hit the super kick on the champ. Is the warrior gonna make it? The warrior is! One, two, no! Chris Jones kicks out. Those knee thrusts right to the face of Chris Jones from the warrior. He goes for the pin. The champ makes the save. Chris Jones and the champ working as a team against the warrior. The warrior double suplexes him. He goes for the pin on both. That would have been a three count on the champ if the ref would have counted both of them. We could have a new champion right now. The warrior looking to do more punishment to the champ. And he hits it. I think the super kick to the warrior. And the spear. The spear to Chris Jones. He's got the pin.
Two, three.
And the champ does it. The champ just with the pin. The champ has retained his title and won hellacious match.
And another warrior with the REM there.
The champ asking for his belt.
Your winner and still champion, Justin Above Par Parsley.
Chris Jones holding up the hand of the champ. And the super kick to the warrior.